Hey guys, it's Alexis and welcome back to my channel. So I am finally back with another video for you guys and I'm super excited to be back filming for you guys. I completely like dodged a bullet with my whole Halloween series, but it's because I'm kind of going through some personal issues right now that I will be posting a video on shortly about, and that's kind of why I haven't been posting, because I've kind of been stressing out about all that this whole month of October. So I didn't get to get any Halloween videos up for you guys, and I'm extremely sorry about that. It literally breaks my heart because I personally love Halloween, I love fall, I love everything about it, and I didn't get to get anything up for you guys. But I'm hoping I can start getting more videos up for you guys slowly but surely. I know it's going to be much more of a slower process just due to what I'm going through. But I hope you guys enjoy the videos that I do get up for you guys. And without further ado, let's just jump
into
the
video. So this video, I'm going to be showing you guys a makeup haul.
I got all this makeup within like the last week up to today. So all this makeup is very recent and what I bought. And I just kind of want to share a few products with you guys. And it's kind of like a fall makeup haul, I guess you guys could say. I kind of been splurging on it, which is bad. Please don't praise me for that because I really need to stop spending money. But like here I am making a fall makeup haul. But without further ado, let's just jump right in. So the first product I got that I'm absolutely obsessed with, I'm using it right now, is the Urban Decay All Nighter Liquid Foundation. And I heard so many mixed reviews about this foundation, to be completely honest with you. And if you do not know that I've been going through this kind of bump where I haven't been able to find a good foundation that fits my skin and that looks really good on me or whatever. So I just kind of been going through millions of foundations. I probably use almost every single foundation in Sephora, which is really bad. But I came across this little baby not too long ago, like a week ago, and I got a sample of it first because I wanted to try it out before I got it, and I used up the whole sample, and I absolutely loved it, so I went and bought me the full thing, and it's the Urban Decay All Nighter Liquid Foundation in shade 4.0, and yeah, it's full coverage, long wear, matte finish, and waterproof and oil-free, which is everything I need. I love a matte finish because I have extremely oily skin, and I need the oil-free, you know. Waterproof is good. I mean, I don't go swimming with makeup, but you know, if it ever comes down to it, this foundation will got me covered, and it's full coverage. So yeah, this is the first product I got. The next product I got is an Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's just a single eyeshadow, and it's in the shade China Rose, and I'm actually wearing it on my eyes right now. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's just like a subtle China Rose color, like something you would see like on those porcelain dolls. It's like a pink like that. And this is just what it looks like. It's just a single eyeshadow and it's in shade China Rose, like I said. And yeah, it's just a single eyeshadow. So that's super cute. And I do not need no more eyeshadows at all. I have so many, but I just thought the color was super cute. I've been kind of obsessed with pink and girly lately. So yeah, that's the next thing I got. The next thing I got is the Benefit Roller Lash Mascara. So, I haven't really been using mascara lately, to be completely honest with you. I've been using lashes, and I just use, like, the mascara to blend in, like, the lashes and my fake lashes. So, I really wanted to try out this mascara because I heard great reviews on it. So, we're gonna see how it works. It's just the Benefit Roller Lash Mascara, and I'm super excited to see how this works. So, that is the next thing out. Just mascara, nothing exciting. The next thing I got, I'm super excited about this one because when I first seen it online, I was absolutely obsessed with it, and I usually don't buy lipsticks online just because I have to see the lipstick in person rather than online, because I know it's going to look different on my skin tone, and once I get it on, and like once it dries and everything, so I know that's not going to be how it looks in person. So I had to go to Ulta after seeing it online, and I bought it, of course. It's the Anastasia Beverly Hills Liquid Lipstick Set, and I think this is a part of one of their holiday gift sets. I'm not sure. I may be wrong. Please excuse me if I am. But yeah, it just comes with the shade Dazed, Bittersweet, and Hudson, and they're just like these three pinky, like, nudes, pinkish brown, warm pink, like rose pink, which is super cute. So let me show y'all them out. I'm wearing one of them now. I'm wearing Bittersweet. So this one is Hudson. The lighter shade right here is Hudson. And then this shade right here in the middle is Bittersweet. And then this shade right here is Daze, the more of the darker rose color. I like the Bittersweet is like the color I have on my lips right now, like a more of a deep brown pink. And then this one right here, Hudson, is more of a like lighter neutral nude pink, which is super cute. I was going to show you guys. So they're all pretty small. It just comes in this little kit right here. If you guys can see, they're mini liquid lipsticks. And I like that because, you know, you could try them all if you want to use it as, like, a trial. I used it because I wanted new liquid lipsticks, and it came with three, so that was, like, a jackpot for me. So, yeah, I just got the liquid lipstick set by Anastasia. The next thing I got is by Anastasia. So, Anastasia, Beverly Hills, is my absolute favorite makeup line, no doubt. So, there's a lot of things from her in here, so you go, girl. So, the next thing I got is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Concealer, and this is just, it looks like it's all beat up. I totally don't take care of my boxes. But this is in shade 2.5, and this concealer is bomb.com. I use it to clean up my eyebrows every single day. That's why it looks like a mess, like eyebrows, but it just comes in this huge jar. It comes with an extreme amount of product, which I absolutely love, because I feel like it's going to last me forever. And it's more of a cream-based concealer, which I'm actually really loving, and it goes on so smoothly, and it blends so well, and it's full coverage. So I absolutely love this concealer. I'm obsessed with it. And I'm thinking maybe to do a product review more in depth on all the products that I actually love. And then I'll do one on the ones I hate because I'm really loving some of these new products. And I usually always buy makeup. I realized I never sat down and did a makeup haul for you guys to show you guys all the makeup like I actually got. Like I've done like collective hauls and all that where I just show you guys all kinds of random things I get. But this is more in depth. So yeah, I just got the Anastasia Beverly Hills Concealer. If you ever see this, get it. It's bomb.com. The next thing I got is surprisingly also by Anastasia Beverly Hills. And it's just the contour kit. I know it's a surprise that you're like, why are you barely getting that in your collection? I'm just barely getting it in my collection. I don't really contour on the daily basis. Like, I hardly ever contour. Like, I only do for pictures because I know there's going to be flashback. So, you know, I don't want to look like completely white out and blurred and ghostly. So that's kind of usually when I use it. I use the banana shade because I've heard so many good reviews about it when I watch reviews with the contour kit. And it really works amazing. I use that to set the powder, like, on my eyes and the concealer and all that. I use that to set it, and it works like a miracle worker. So this is just what it looks like. It comes with the six shades and the bronzers. I usually use this light bronzer right there, the shade Banana. Those are mainly the only two colors I've used in this palette, but I absolutely love it. It works amazing, and I hope to use it more. I hope to start becoming the contour pro, you know, have the sharp line. I hope to become more like that. But yeah, I just got the contour kit by Anastasia, like I already said a million times. The next thing I got is also by, guess who? Anastasia. So I just got the glow kit. I'm not sure. This is the ultimate glow. I'm sure. It's the ultimate glow highlighting kit, and this one is super cute. It's so bomb. I love this one compared to all her other ones because it has like a big mirror in it. And like it's like oof, like you could see yourself in it. Like I'm gonna show you guys what it's gonna glare. I'll show like a portion of it. So see, there's like somewhat of a mirror, and then these are all the colors right here, which I'm absolutely obsessed with. I love that rose or amber gold color. It's called amber gold, but it's rose gold. It's so pretty. I love the mirror because like when I'm putting on my makeup, I could see it so well, you know? It's like it's a big mirror that you could see yourself in, like inside. So yeah, I really like that. I feel like she outdid herself with this palette. I think it looks so pretty. And it has just all the pretty winter colors. I like snow because I have really light complexion in my skin. That doesn't even make sense. My complexion is really light, like I'm white, like literally as white as snow. So the snow color, I feel like it looks really nice on my skin, and I'm absolutely obsessed with the shade snow. I like the shade rose gold, or amber gold, whatever, because I really like the rose gold shade, and it looks pretty with like pink makeup and like blush, and yeah. So I really like this highlighting palette. The next thing I got, it's another highlighting palette, and this one is the Sleek Makeup Highlighting Palette. So this is the most recent one I got, and I heard a lot about this like throughout social media. If you guys know Daisy Marquez, I'm sure you guys do. Nikki Tutorials and all that. I've heard them review this a lot, so you know I just kind of had to see what the hype is, because when I see something that's really hyped about or by the queens of like glowing to the gods, I have to try out the highlight. So I just tested out the Sleek Highlighting Palette. I picked it up at Sephora. And this is just what it looks like. It's a reflective one. It's small. I was so surprised when I got it. I was shocked. I thought it was a bigger palette, but it's really small. Like literally I could fit this in my back pocket and take it with me everywhere I go. But yeah, that's the highlight I'm using now. If you guys could see, I don't know if you guys could see. But that's the highlight I'm using now currently as we speak. So yeah, it's super cute and I'm low-key obsessed with it. This one also has a mirror. I'm gonna blur it out for you guys. So those are the colors right there. It comes with like this purpley shade and then this like orangey nude shade and then yellow shade and then the cream one. I haven't used the cream yet just because I haven't really figured out how to work it. My review kind of on this product is it's not as amazing as they put it out there to be, but if you build up the product, I feel like you could really get the ultimate glow and it is as good as they say. You know, I wish it would have been as like one streak and you're glowing to the gods like it is with Anastasia highlights. It's not like that, but if you build it up like second or third layer, you're gonna have a nice pretty glowing highlight, you know. So I really like it. Something fun, something different and cute. So that's the story to behind why I got this palette, because I was hearing raves about it, so I had to try it. The next thing I got is basic. It's just the MAC Studio Fix Powder Plus Foundation. This is the powder foundation I use every day, 24/7. This is my go-to powder foundation, so if you ever wonder what powder foundation I use or which powder foundation you should use, I would try the Studio Fix because this powder foundation works miracles and it's full coverage, so that's what I like about it because I need full coverage. And yeah, I really like it, and I'm in the shade NC20. Yeah. The next thing I got is by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is now also another trend I'm way behind on. So I normally only use Dip Brow Pomade for my brows just because, I don't know, I've been so biased, like I really like my eyebrows to look sharp and finished and Instagram glam every single day. But then I came to realizations, I can't do that every day because that's doing too much, like for me. Like, I actually have to take my time when I do it and it gets really messy. The pomade gets really messy, you know. So when I don't feel like a mess, it's just like, ugh. But, so that's kind of why I went with this. I went with the Brow Wiz and this is actually amazing. It's a little bit different for me. It's something to get used to. It's definitely more natural, which I'm kind of liking. I'm trying to go, you know, on a little bit more natural side with my makeup lately. I've been kind of trying to go natural, you know, not do the Instagram brow thing every day. Like maybe if I film a video or if I'm going out or whatever. I did use the Brow Wiz on my video. I did use the Brow Wiz on my eyebrows now just because, you know, I'm making the video on it. So I gotta show you guys how it looks. I don't know if you guys can tell the difference. Let's see. Like, see, they're much more like, I don't know, I feel like they look much more natural to me, and that's kind of why I went with it. And I'm in the shade Chocolate in the Brow Wiz. If you don't have the Brow Wiz and you're debating to try it, I would try it out. It's definitely more different, it's more natural, so it just comes with a little spoolie on the end, which is very convenient, you know, when you're doing brows and then you're trying to look for the spoolie, you just pull it out and it just goes, you know, so it's so much easier. And then this is just the pencil on the end. Let me show you guys how it looks. Like, it's like right there. See, it's a very fine line. It's nothing too intense or too dark, and you're just like, oh my gosh, that's so dark. But yeah. The next thing I got, I'm gonna show you guys, I'm saving the best for last right now, but let me show you guys. So I picked up some lashes today. Well, I picked up one of them today. I picked up the other ones like the beginning of the week, last week. So I picked up the lashes I'm wearing now, and they're by Ardell, and they're called the Wispies, and it just says Wispies Black. It doesn't say what number, but they're the lashes I'm wearing now. So it's just with the red Wispies. I love Ardell lashes. They're bomb.com. And you can find them at drugstores and anywhere, so try them out. So I just got those ones. And then I got the Ardell Glamour in number 105 in black. And these are just the other lashes I have. These ones are probably my natural go-to. These ones will probably be my natural go-to also. This is my first time wearing them, like, right now. So, yeah, those are just the two lashes I tried out. And then the last thing I got, ready, 3, 2, 1, is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture Palette. Let me tell you, I am obsessed with this. I was dying to get it as soon as it came out, but I didn't end up getting it right away because, you know, a girl has to save her money to get it, but it is so beautiful. I love, like, this mint color going. Super cute for fall. Like, it's in this, like, mustard yellow. It's so cute. And I think I'm a little bit much of an eyeshadow palette hoarder because I have so many eyeshadow palettes, and it's kind of bad, but, you know, YOLO, right? But, yeah, these are just the colors on them. Oh shoot, the brush. But yeah, those are the colors on them, and I'm super obsessed with them. I'm obsessed with this palette. I have to do looks on these. I'm definitely going to be doing some fall looks on them. And yeah, I'm super obsessed with this palette. When I seen it, I knew I had to get it from the moment I seen it, and I finally got my eyes on it. I also have the Modern Renaissance one. Let me show y'all what they look like next to each other. trying to show you off. So this is them. They are the exact same. Well, not the exact same, but like they're this meant to be in the same thing. And just, you know what I mean. But yeah, this is them by each other. Super cute. My subculture is way more cleaner than the modern renaissance, obviously, because I beat this one up way more, a million more times. And then this one's so cute, and I'm just so obsessed. So yeah, I just got this subculture palette for y'all, or for me, for whoever, for y'all to see. I gotta get my brush. I dropped my brush down there. Not good. Alright. So, this is everything I got in this makeup haul. I mean, it's a lot of stuff that I've got within a week. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button. And comment down below. Tell me what you guys thought about this. And if you want to see more videos like this, I could definitely do more makeup hauls for you guys. Because I could assure you guys, I literally waste my money on all makeup, on all kinds of makeup, so that's not good. That's not something I should be bragging about. But I waste my money a lot on makeup. So if you guys would like to see more frequent makeup hauls, more makeup looks, whatever you guys want to see, just let me know down below in the comments and I'll be sure to get that out for you guys. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!